All right, Matt, UFC 243 coming at us live from Marvel Stadium in Melbourne, Australia. Listen, there's going to be over 56,000 people there live for this event. One of the biggest and most attended events that we've ever seen in the UFC. I mean, it's comparable to UFC 193 that they had in Australia, but also UFC 129 from the Rogers Center in Toronto, Canada. And listen, some more local connections here. Had the chance to see Yorgan De Castro in his fight at NEF 36 when he was taking on Ross Sasquatch Hilton. He was able to win the promotion's Cruiserweight Championship on that night. You can find that fight on YouTube. I'll link it down below. But Matt, what can you tell us about De Castro? I mean, he's a heavy hitter, hands like cinder blocks. He's 5-0 as a pro. But what have you seen from him lately?
Well, most people know him from his Dana White Tuesday Night Contender Series appearance. He looked really good in that fight. He was a massive underdog going into it. But
Plus 550.
Yeah, exactly. And it was just a lot of overhands, a lot of good leg kicks. And that's really what you're going to see from him. He's not the most technical guy on planet Earth. He's not the fastest guy on planet Earth. But when he does land, he's going to put people to sleep. And with Justin Tafa, neither one of us were overly familiar with his career. So we went back and we watched all his professional fights, all three of them. So it wasn't that hard, and they all end it pretty quickly. He's kind of like a Yorgan De Castro with way more speed. That's the best way of describing him.
So, I mean, Justin Tafa fights out of Tafa MMA, and the reason why I'm saying that is because his brother, Junior Tafa, is a 20-5 pro kickboxer. He's ranked 10th in the world in Glory. I mean, he's 3-4 with Glory, but out of his 20 wins, 16 of them by knockout. This guy also possesses great power. He can also throw really good leg kicks, but if you look at some of his previous performances, it's that ridiculous hand speed where he's able to pull off these crazy combos. And oh yeah, by the way, he also trains with Mark Hunt and Tai Tuivasa, and those are some pretty decent training partners. And as far as the odds are concerned in this fight, Tafa -125 favorite, De Castro a slight underdog, you know, +105, +110, Matt. Who are you picking in this
one? I'm going to have to go with the favorite, Tafa, with this. I just feel like both guys have very similar skill sets. It's just one guy has so much more speed than the other that it's going to be the X factor.
I'm going to go with Tafa as well. And this is actually a really fun fight to kick off our main card. I know Raquel Pennington, Holly Holm off the card due to a pulled hamstring on Holly Holm's end. But still, this is an awesome fight and everyone should actually be really excited. You can expect fireworks in this one. I'm anticipating a finish either guy, but I mean, picking Tafa here, Matt. The UFC 243 Fight Night Picks 2-Minute Breakdowns here on YouTube. Let's get into it.